This is just a rough patch. It's temporary. This pandemic is not forever. It will pass.
Thank you so much for still being here and for doing your best despite all odds. Be grateful for what we have right now and be happy.
I know these are scary times that our generation has to face.
Success can also be determined by having these values.
Promise you much, you'll be fine.
Hi, I'm Sarah and I'm the school captain for this term 2021. So this pandemic hit us about 2 years ago and we're still in it. And it's taken a toll on all of us, you know, mentally, emotionally, physically. And we've been exposed to this new normal of online classes, okay? So I'm going to be real with you because I'd be a hypocrite if I tell you otherwise. Most of the time, I just join the class and then I either go back to sleep, get on Netflix or TikTok. It's either those three, there's no fourth alternative. And with homework, I just procrastinate my way through it, let it pile up, and then freak out and get stressed when I need to pass it out. And I know a lot of you are relating to what I'm saying right now, because we are doing it, or we've done it before. So I'm not going to tell you to be productive, focus, don't procrastinate, no. I'm going to tell you to find yourself a coping mechanism, okay? Find a way to deal with all of these emotions that you're feeling. I know what you're feeling. You're feeling drained, tired, demotivated, feeling of wanting to give up. We are all going through this. You're not alone in this, okay? You're not alone. So don't feel like, oh, I'm the only one doing this. I'm so behind on my studies. Everybody else is catching up. No, we are all feeling the same way and we've all gone through this rough patch, okay? So my encouragement to you, my advice, is to find yourself a coping mechanism. Find a way to deal with all these emotions, to get your mind off these things that you're feeling. Okay, because it is not healthy to be feeling this way constantly throughout the whole day. You know, find some way to cope with it, be it Netflix, cooking, sewing, whatever it is. You know, so what if you're behind on a few assignments or you don't focus during a few classes? Is that really more important than your mental health? No, it's really not. Okay, you matter. Prioritize yourself. Okay, so find a way to deal with that, because I think if you can deal with this pandemic, you can get through anything, okay? Do what makes you happy, do what makes you content, do what makes you feel most like yourself. You may be feeling like, you know, you're so drained, you don't even recognize yourself anymore. This is not the person you were. You were so productive last time. Whatever it is, you do what makes you happy, you do what makes you feel like yourself, and you prioritize yourself because you matter. Your mental health matters. There will be that special something that helps you cope with this fully. My coping mechanism is Netflix for lifers. So find that something and you can get through this. Okay, you're not alone. That is my words of advice and encouragement to you. Use it, don't use it, whatever. Do what makes you happy. So that's it for me. Bye.
Hey guys, I don't have much to say except how proud I am, and I'm sure everyone is, of each and every one of you. The past year hasn't been at all easy, and that really is an understatement. Thank you so much for still being here and for doing your best despite all odds. I hope you give yourselves a pat on the back, and please don't be too hard on yourselves. I know the future is filled with uncertainty and that it all seems really bleak. I just hope that before you see how far you have to go, you also see how far you've come. I wish all of you the very best for high school. Please take good care of yourselves and don't hesitate to reach out for help if you need it. Stay safe and goodbye.
Hi everyone, I'm Audrey So-Chin-Chi, co-captain 1 for term 2021. So the past 2 years have been a really tough time for every one of us, I believe. And it's such a pity that the COVID-19 pandemic has robbed us of our time in CBN. Celebrating Hariguru, Everybody's Day, Chinese New Year, and having all the fun activities for moments that I believe we all miss. And of course, having classes in school. Yeah, we definitely miss that too. Things just don't go our way. But that's okay, you know? Be grateful for what we have right now and be happy. We don't know when we will be able to go back to school, and for the Form 5s, we may not even be given the privilege to have classes face-to-face anymore. But here's the thing, we shouldn't dwell on that, and we should probably make peace with it. We should be grateful for the past experiences, the memories we've made in school, and make new ones that are equally fun, equally amazing right now. But I just want to remind you and me to be kind. ourselves, and that our worth isn't determined by our productivity or anything at all. Okay, we determine our own worth and we choose our own happiness. That was so corny, but it's true. Yeah, so it's okay to feel tired, just take a break. One last thing, we should never lose hope. There's always hope for this pandemic to end and for things to return to normal. So if you ever need someone to talk to, you need help, you know, you need support, don't be afraid to reach out to your teachers, your school counselors, and also friends. Yeah, so until then, stay at home and stay safe. Bye.
Hi everyone, my name is Ern See, and I know everyone is going through tough times right now. Some of you may be feeling unmotivated to wake up every day. Some of you may be feeling anxious from the uncertainty of the future. And some of you may be struggling to find hope to move forward. And I know how hard it is to wake up every day and to be expected to function like a normal human being as though the pandemic didn't happen. And if you're feeling like this, I just want to say that it's okay to feel like that. You are completely valid to feel like that. And it may seem like life has come to a stop with so many plans on hold, but we will all get through it together. And if you're watching this and you realize you haven't talked to your friends for months, please reach out to your friends, because you never know, a simple text or a simple call can change someone's life or can even make someone's day. And if you're someone that is feeling like they're alone for months and hasn't talked to your friends for weeks or months as well, please talk to your friends. And if you can't even have the energy to do so, then I sincerely hope that you will slowly find the courage and hope to move forward.
Hi everyone, my name is Ryan and I'm the co-captain too for term 2021. I personally don't have any inspirational quotes on my own, yeah, but I do have some inspirational / motivational quotes that I live by. So I'm going to share some of those quotes with you guys. With that being said, let's kick this video off with one of the most inspiring speeches of all time.
You know what inspires me? Fearlessness, drive. I hate lazy people. Bob, stay in school. Don't you ever be lazy. Don't you ever complain about hard work. Work hard and pay more.
Okay.
You know what inspires me?
So the message that Nikki's trying to tell us is that you can do anything that you put your mind to. So remember guys, work hard because it pays off. And let's watch the second video.
Body of research that shows that skills like resilience and conscientiousness can be just as important to your success as your test scores or even your IQ. For instance, West Point cadets who scored high on things like grit and determination were more likely to complete basic training than those who rank high on things like class rank, SAT scores, and physical fitness. If you're willing to dig deep, if you're willing to pick yourself up when you fall, if you're willing to work and work until your weaknesses become your strengths, then you'll develop a set of skills that you can mold and apply to any situation you encounter.
If you guys want to watch the full video, just search Michelle Obama, How to Succeed in Life. What I understand from Michelle Obama's speech is that success can also be determined by having these values, like being steadfast in duty. I think that it is important for us to have those values in life to be successful. So I guess that's all for me. Thank you for watching. Bye.